Hello friends, welcome to our channel Global Tech Learn. To get data from multiple queries or sources into a single table, we use the append query option available in Power BI, which is similar to union option available in SQL database to combine two tables. So as you can see here, we have a sales data from January to September for year 2019 is maintained in dataset 1. And for the month November to December for year 2019, sales data is maintained in dataset 2. The structure for these two sources is almost similar and it maintains the same kind of data. So instead of maintaining two data sets, we want to append these sources and get in a single data set. For today's example, I have a sales data in SQL database. This is a historical data. An incremental data for the sales is maintained in the Excel file. We have to load these two sources in Power BI and get into a single query. Go to Transform Data. First, let's load the data from a SQL. So we need the sales table. Select the sales table and click on OK. Now let's load the data from Excel, which contains our incremental sales data. Select the file and click on open. So you can see this Excel has three sheets. Let's see what data it has. So select the sheet one and in the preview we can see we have a data. Sheet 2 is blank and sheet 3 is blank. So select sheet 1 and click on OK. Also, let's check the data count in both the queries now. Sales table which we have loaded from SQL and we'll count the rows for this table. So it has 1147 records. And Excel data has 1000 records. Close and apply. Now we'll check what is detail in both these two queries. In the sales table, which we have loaded from a SQL, you can see it has the data from 1st January 2018 till 21st December 2019. And the Excel, which we have loaded, it has the data for 31st December 2019. Also, if we go to the report view, there will be two queries for the sales data available for plotting the analysis. So we have to combine these two datas into a single query. So go to the transform data again. First, let's give a meaningful name to the Excel. Incremental sales. As both these two tables contain a similar structure data, instead of maintaining two queries, we want this data into a single table. So we can do that by using an append query option. Select a sales table which we have loaded using a SQL database and click on the append query option. In append query, it will further provide you two options, append queries and append queries as a new. So what is the difference between these? When you select the append query option, the data from the second table gets combined with the data of the first table in the first table itself. But when you select the option append queries as a new, the data from these two sources will get combined and it will create a new query. So let's check how append query works. I have selected append query. Fact sales table is already selected and now it will ask us which query data you want to append in this table. So let's select the incremental sales and click on OK. If you have only two tables, you can select the two table option. If there are three or more tables which you want to append, then you select the option three or more table and then provide your queries into the tables to append list. So we have two tables. I am selecting two tables, selected table incremental sale and click on OK. So you can see data appending is done and my step has been documented under applied step. Let's check the count in both the queries now. So I'm selecting fact sales, go to the transform and select count rows. So now you can see my rows in the fact sale has increased to 2147. Initially in the fact sales, the records were 1147 and in the incremental sales, the records were 1000. So now incremental sales data has appended in the fact sales and you can see the count for this query is 2147 and the count for incremental sales is 1000. Let's close and apply and see what data we get in the sales table. So in sales table, initially we had a data till 21st of December and 31st December data was in the incremental sales. So now you can see it has a 31st December data also and its original data is also there. So it has combined the data from incremental sales into the fact sale table. Now go to the transform data tab again. Also, you can see the append query step is documented under applied step for the fact cell only and not in the incremental cell. This is because we have performed action on the fact cell and not the incremental sales query. In report view, you can see we still have two queries available for plotting the analysis even though we have appended our data from incremental sales in a fact sales and we have all our required data in a fact sales query. We don't require incremental sales query here anymore for plotting the analysis. So how we can hide this? So again go to the transform data tab. Select incremental sales, right click on it. And this enable load, you have to uncheck this box. Continue. Then close and apply. Now you can see only the sales query where we have appended the data is available for plotting visuals and do our analysis. Now go to the transform data tab again. And cancel the action which we performed earlier. So now fact sale has its own data and incremental sale has its own data. You can see in fact sale 2018 data is present and incremental sale 2019 data is present. Now we want to append these two queries and create a new query. So select the append query option and click on append query as new. So first table is a fact table and let's select the second table as an incremental sale and click on OK. So now you will see it has created a third query which is a combined result of sales table and incremental sales. So here we'll get a data for 2018 for 2019. Again, let's check the count for this new query which is created, which is a combination of sales and the incremental sales. So go to transform and select count row. So our records are 2147. So in this way, we can append two or multiple sources which have almost similar structure and similar data. So instead of having multiple queries for those multiple similar structure data sources, we can append and create into a single query. If you find this video useful, then please do like, share and subscribe our channel Global Tech Learn. Also mention in the comment section if you want us to cover any other topic related to Power BI. and we'll be back with more such learning videos. Till then, take care.